A lot of the stuff we talk about on this channel is how to leverage no code with actual business use cases. But today in this video, I'm gonna be breaking it down for you in a different light. I'm gonna be using some no code software to help me build a better system to manage a friendly poker tournament. No business use case here, just a couple of folks playing cards. So if learning about how no code can help us manage a poker tournament better is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. One of our favorite no-code tools is SmartSuite, and we're gonna be using SmartSuite and Make in this particular video to build a really cool automation to help us manage poker tournament invitations. But before we get to that, I wanna first invite you to join me for a free training. If you're new to no-code, you will want to understand how to leverage no-code automation. No-code automation is a little bit tricky when you're first picking it up, but I've got a webinar presentation that's gonna break down the fundamentals for you so that you can start leveraging no-code automation. Grab that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Sign up for free and you'll get that training right in your inbox. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. If you already have a SmartSuite account, plop yours open. Feel free to follow along. If you don't, be sure to sign up using our affiliate link. You will get your free trial set up right away. Now, inside of my SmartSuite solution, you see I've built a brand new solution. I have named it Poker Tournament, and I have three key applications. So my applications are tournaments, members, and invitations. So let's talk about what each one of these different data sets does, because that's really what an application is. It's just a data set to collect information. So the idea here is that we are putting on a recurring poker tournament. The tournament might be September 1st of this year. Maybe in a couple quarters we do it again at a different location, but it's using the same core group of people who might join the tournament. Now, this is an actual live example because, in fact, I have a good friend who reached out and said, man, I'm having a really hard time managing the poker tournament, and this guy puts on an awesome tournament about once a quarter, and about, you know, 20 to 30 folks show up and we just do a nice little house game, but he puts a lot of work into it. He's putting in a lot of food, he's taking care of beverages, he's hosting the thing, there are prizes. So as you might imagine, he's putting in a good amount of money and he wants to make sure that when he sends out invitations, people actually show up. So that is the actual thing that we're doing here. We want people to reserve the right to attend. So we're sending out a bunch of invitations and it's gonna be a first come, first serve acceptance. But after so many of these have been received, well, then that's it. We can only allow so many people to attend because there's only so much space and only so many seats. So that's the idea that we're working on solving. So the first application is, as you see, tournaments. So here's where we're giving out the information about what's the date of this tournament. Here I've picked a date of October 14th. I have a start time here of 7 p.m. and I've got a location. Of course, the location could move around. I intentionally used a single select field here, rather than actually putting in the location or the address field type. And this allows me to then add new locations kind of on the fly, and I don't have to worry about some of the restrictions that come along with the SmartSuite address field. Now, I also, of course, have my ID here, and if we take a look at this, I'm just combining some information, the date of the tournament and the location, so I'm getting something that says October 14th at Poker's Cove. If I added another one here, I could set it up, pick a different date, let's say this was sometime in April. Well, I could assign it to the same or add a new location. Of course, bring in a new time. Let's make this one start at 5:30 p.m. And once all this information is in here, we're gonna see it reflected here in that primary field. All right, now ideally what we wanna do is send out invitations to all our members, but we have to first look at our members' application. Over here in our members app, what we see is we have standard member information with the full name here. We're using a full name field, and we've specifically toggled in first and last names. And then we also, of course, collect emails and phone numbers, And most importantly, I have a status. The idea here is that maybe certain folks come in and out of the group over time. Some of them might play with us during certain months. Some of them may move to inactive. Maybe we want to keep a record of them and say, hey, at one point in time, we did play poker with Elmo, although Elmo has moved to inactive. So this status field is really important. When we send out invitations to our next tournament, we only want to send out those invitations to active members. Okay, now, our last table here is the invitations. And as you can see, we already set up some invitations here for the Pokers tournament that's going to be going on October 14th at Poker's Cove. And of course, we've sent out these applications or these invitations, one to every member. So this is what's called a junction application. A junction application connects two other applications. In this case, it's connecting tournaments and it's connecting members. And in each instance, we're connecting to one tournament and one member, but we're able to get granular precision on the specific intersection of those two things. So specifically, Doc Holliday, his attendance at Poker's Cove tournament on October 14th. Have we even heard back from him? Well, if we hear back, then we'll say, yes, we received a response. And then it will matter on whether he's told us that he is attending or not. Either yes or no. So we are able to track it this way, how many people have RSVP'd to a specific tournament so that we can make sure not to exceed a certain number of seats. So how do we create these things automatically? Well, that's exactly what we have to solve in the first part of our data setup. And we are going to be using Make in order to build this slightly more complicated automation. Let's go ahead and hop into Make and I'll show you how we're going to do this one step at a time from our tournaments application when somebody checks the box and says they are ready to create invitations. Then we want to send out all those invitations by creating a new record here against the tournament and every individual member specifically who is active inside of our system. All right, let's go ahead and hop on into Make and take this one step at a time. The first step obviously is to create a new scenario. And if you haven't already done so, you'll need to integrate your Make account with SmartSuite. So I'm gonna go ahead and find SmartSuite from the list here. And I am going to set it up with watching updated records. This is an instant trigger from SmartSuite, although in full transparency, sometimes it takes just a few moments before it actually triggers. But what I want to say is, hey, inside of SmartSuite, I'm going to add a hook. Let's go ahead and add one here. I'm establishing my SmartSuite connection, and I have to sync it up to my proper solution. In this case, it's called Poker Tournament. I find it from the list. And then I'm gonna be telling it what application to watch. For us, we are gonna be making a selection, checking a box inside of our tournaments application. So I make that selection here and I save up this webhook. So now any change to a record inside of my tournaments application will trigger this automation. That's both good and bad. I certainly don't want the whole automation to run just if I update a time or maybe I update a date or a location. I don't want the whole thing to run automatically from there. So I'm gonna have to put in some stipulations that say, well, this might trigger the automation, but I only want you to run under certain conditions beyond here. But I'm getting ahead of myself. The next thing we need to do is to find all of the active people inside of our members application. So inside of SmartSuite, our next step is to again go into SmartSuite and we're going to find records. Note that there's a big difference between get a record. Get a record is a single record and we're gonna find a single record by a field match or a syntax search. That's not what we want. We want to find multiple records by field match or SmartSuite search syntax. Let me show you how we do this. We find records. Again, we have to determine which application and solution. So our solution is Poker Tournament. Wait for that to load. And then the application here, we're searching for members. We want to find all of the active members. So here we can come in and say, well, in a particular field in our members application. For us, this is going to be the status field. What is the search value we're looking for? Well, for us, again, we have two different status inside of our status field. It can either be active or inactive. Since I only want to return the active members, I'm going to make sure to type in active here. For you, whatever your search criteria is, you can establish it right here. Now we're asked, how many different numbers of records do we want to return? We can find as many as 200, so I will allow the maximum. I will say, bring back as many as you find, as many active members as are inside of that application, bring them back right here. Now, that's it for this step. We have now found all of the active records inside of our members table. Now for the last piece, what we want to do is create a new record inside of our Junction table, one record for each active member that we found that links to the active member and links to the tournament that initiated the automation. So let's get into this. What we want to add here is actually a tool. We come down to our flow control and we find the iterator option. We can drag that in, and what the iterator allows us to do is perform a function or perform an automation any number of times. So it's asking us for the array here. Essentially, what this wants to know is, how many times am I going to iterate and what am I iterating on? Well, for us, what we're going to be iterating on is the actual records that we found in our second module. So if we look here, we have total number of bundles, and we can just bring that in for our array. This is going to mean that our array, our iterator, performs as many times as it found bundles. If it found 10 active members, it's going to perform 10 times. If it found 20 active members, it'll perform 20 times. You get the idea. Now, everything to the right of this iterator is going to be what we are doing. What are we actually performing? Well, inside of SmartSuite, what I want to do, I know all the records. I know the long list of records, but I want to go in one at a time and create a new record that links to that record. So let's go take this one step at a time. What I need to do now is create a new record inside of my invitations Junction table, and I want to do it for every single person that I found that was active inside of our members. So let's go ahead and do that now. Inside of SmartSuite, I will create a record. Now I have to map it up again to my solution, which I've called Poker Tournament. Here it is. And then I have to find the application that I want to make my new records in. And for us, it's going to be in our invitations. Let's go ahead and bring that in now. And what I need to do, if we flip back into SmartSuite, is I need to create a new record with the tournament that initiated the automation, but also the member that I found in the previous steps. So let's go back, and now I want to map out appropriately. What's the tournament? Well, the tournament came from our first module. When we, in module one here, when we first initiated the automation, this is the ID of the tournament that I want to create all my records on behalf of. But that's not all. Now I also need to get into my members. How do I know which member it is? Well, remember, we found this bundle of records in this previous step. So which one is this? I found 10 different records. In this example, I want to use this particular ID. This is the ID that we found in this particular step. And remember that we are going to perform this action the number of times we're iterating for each bundle that we found. If we found 10, we're going to create 10 of these, each time using a new ID in this process. Let's go ahead and say okay. And since that's all we need to do for this particular automation, I am going to save it and turn it on. Be sure to go ahead and set that all up. Now, one final thing that I mentioned earlier that we didn't quite get to yet, we want to make sure that this automation only performs when we have checked the box. So I can actually set up a filter that says, only under certain conditions are we going to move on to the second module inside of this process. So make sure this is ready to create invitations. So we're going to be watching that checkbox. So we can set up these conditions and say something like, create invitations is equal to true, because create invitations is a Boolean value. It's either true or false. So this way we can say, only if you've checked the box for create invitations are we going to do this. But wait, we want to make sure that we don't uncheck the box and check the box and uncheck the box and check the box. We don't want this to run over and over again. So I'm going to add an additional rule that says, and I'm going back here now, and I'm going to make sure that I don't already have connections built to invitations. So link to invitations needs to be empty. It needs to have no values there. That means if I've already created links to invitations for the specific tournament, I never want it to work again. So I'm going to insist that number one, I'm ready to create invitations. That's true. But number two, that I've never created invitations for this particular tournament before. These are my conditions to make sure that I don't accidentally run this automation over and over again. Let's save it again. Let's make sure it's on. And let's flip on back into SmartSuite. And we're going to go flip back into our tournaments. And we're going to make sure to check the box for our new upcoming tournament and what we will want the automation to do. It's going to take a moment or two in the background. We want it to now go into our members. It should find 10 active members inside of our registration page here. And then we want it to create 10 new records for those members against the new tournament that we just selected. So on my initial push, I actually found that I put something in incorrectly. So let's go ahead and rewind. I was able to fix it, and I'll show you exactly how I was able to troubleshoot this error. So what wound up happening, if we back up here, is that here on this particular time, this particular instance, my automation was triggered, but it did not pass the filter. And why not? Well, we see that create invitations was true. It met that criteria, but the link to invitations, the way I put this in, I meant to say it does not exist. And the way I put that in did not quite make sense for Make. So I had to go back and change things. Here is the update that I made to that filter. Going into the new update, I changed it to say that the link to invitations, that is from our tournament application, when we link to invitations, it needs to be equal to null. It's pretty much the same thing as does not exist, but it's apparently different for Make. So I was able to try this second one and I had a successful run of the automation. So that's the change that needs to happen. Let's pop now back into the history and take a look at what comes out of it. So we can click on into this particular run history and see that this automation performed multiple times. And this is exactly what we would expect, right? So let's go through what this automation did. It was triggered off of one record, one new tournament, April 16th, right here at Poker's Cove. It passed through our criteria because we have a new invitation that is ready to be sent out. And this particular tournament has not yet sent invitations. Then what we do is we go into SmartSuite and we find all of the active members. Notice that they are coming into us in all these different bundles. So each bundle is a particular active member. This one is Big Bird. We can scroll down. This next one is, well, you get the idea. We can drill into these. Here's Bat Masterson. Over and over again, we're finding all the information for all the different active members inside of our automation. Now we go to the iterator and we are going to iterate 10 different times because we've got 10 different things to iterate on, 10 different active members. And then what do? Well, we have to create each one of these different members inside of our new Junction application. So let's go ahead and pop into our application here. You'll see that now we have links here for all of our different members, but let's go ahead and switch on over to our invitations and you will see all of those new invitations created for the 10 active members. Note that we did not create an invitation for our inactive member, Elmo. So because of the fact that when we searched for all of our active members, Elmo is inactive, there will not exist a link here to any of the inactive members, namely Elmo. This is the first step in this whole process, but if you're interested in watching as we build out more of this system, be sure to tune in for Part 2. I know we covered a lot in this video, so if you have questions, be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.